Do you want to make mixed reality videos like this one within like 5 minutes? All you need is this and this. And you can do it anywhere you want, like in the bedroom, kitchen, or even the bathroom if you wanted to. No more green screen needed. For those who don't know what mixed reality is, let me quickly explain. This is a recording method that mixes the real world, so you, with the game world in real time. So the mixed reality capture looks like you are inside a VR game, and usually it showcases well what it feels like playing VR games. So these videos are fun to make because you can send these to friends and family and show off a little. But you know, I've been making these kinds of videos for years now, and the process used to take hours, a full day even, to get right, and doing that just to show off was just not worth it. But now Liv released a mobile app, making it so easy that I highly recommend everyone to try it out. So if you want to know how, then you should watch this video and subscribe for more. But before we jump into this guide, a quick thanks to the sponsor of today's video, the charming VR movie Madrid Noir. Madrid Noir is a 45-minute immersive theatrical experience that unfolds across two acts. But think Pixar animation movies, except in VR, so you'll be in the film yourself. The story is set in 1920s Madrid, where a young woman named Lola arrives at her uncle's apartment after he was declared dead. She soon finds out there's something more about her shadowy uncle, and you join Lola in a series of flashbacks to try to uncover that mystery.
It wasn't just during the day either. He was always sneaking out at nighttime.
I like this experience because classic noir movies inspire it, and it cleverly meshes up the crime drama suspense with humor and light interactive elements. Yes, you will help out, like at some point you'll search through the uncle's belongings in search of hidden clues, or use a camera to capture photos of the estranged uncle as he goes on one of his weird midnight strolls. But it does so in a way that it doesn't distract you from the simple yet intriguing story. If this doesn't capture you yet, then do it for the characters and animations, as they are so endearing. It's family friendly too, so anyone can get Madrid Noir now on Oculus Quest for $9. I'd say grab your headset, use the link in the description, and enjoy. Okay, let's get started. So keep in mind that this app is in beta, so it could be buggy and improvements will come over time. But it already works, so this is what you need: an iOS device like an iPhone or iPad, at least generation iPhone XR or iPad 2018 or above, because you need the Apple A12 or higher chipset. Yes, this time it's not for Android users yet, but it is coming soon. Last thing you need is your Oculus Quest. This should work with both Quest 1 and Quest 2. Time for step 1, installing required apps. So open your browser on your iOS device and navigate to liv.tv/mobile. You will see this page, click on download on test flight. You need to download test flight first, an app that allows you to test beta versions of apps, because the Liv mobile app is on there. So click on view in app store, open it and install it like you usually do. Then go back to the browser, click on start testing at step 2, then click on accept, then install. While you wait, let's download the Quest app too. So on your Oculus Quest, you have to download Liv Connect, which is available via App Lab. You can use the link in the description or put on your Quest, and in the store, search for Liv Connect, open the App Lab section by clicking View App, then click on the app and click on View Details. Accept the prompt and download it from there. Once done, you can start Liv Connect, grant it storage permission if it asks, which is an important step, so do it. Now, put down your headset and let's go to step 2. Setup. Now, I recommend putting the iOS device on a tripod or lean it against the wall or some books or something. You can then open up your camera app to check if it all looks good and that you can stand in front of it. Yes, it is way easier to do it with somebody else, but I was alone, so yeah, it is possible as well. Then in your Oculus Quest, make sure to draw your guardian around your iOS device. I noticed that it is best if your iPhone or iPad is also in the guardian, so I drew the guardian around it with a bit more space in the front so I can stand there and play games. Once you've done that, let's move on to the next step, connecting the apps. Grab your iOS device, then open the Liv app. If it's your first time starting this app, it will give you a pop-up. Allow it. Then click next, then start testing. you will need to give the app access to the camera. It will also ask you to install the Quest app, but we did that already, so just click install and then go back because for some reason you cannot cancel it yet. So those are just initial steps that won't appear again. And then you will see this screen. Click continue and select mixed reality mode. This screen will show up that says enter headset. So put on your Oculus Quest, but first make sure you check your Wi-Fi settings on both devices. You need to be connected to the same local Wi-Fi network as your iOS device. If that's the case, launch Lift Connect and it should now connect to your iOS device. So the next step is to align your controllers. Now make sure your headset stays on by putting the headset on your forehead or putting your finger or tape over the proximity sensor, or just keep it on your head and look through your nose gap, which is what I did. You should also make sure you're not walking outside of your Guardian, as it can become buggy when that happens. Then follow the screens on your iOS device to align the controllers. What you have to do is put your right controller onto the ring on the screen, hold the trigger for like 3 seconds and it should be aligned. In your headset, you should see a virtual overlay of your phone in the correct position. If it looks correct, click on confirm on the iOS device. You may have to wait a couple of seconds before this button is clickable. A preview screen opens up, and if you wave your hands in front of the camera now, you can check whether your controllers are aligned. If the controllers seem off, then you can redo the steps again until it looks good. Then walk in front of your camera where you would like to be recorded and recenter by holding the Oculus button on the right controller. This is to make sure the mixed reality view looks good. It will be helpful if someone can help you out here, but if you don't, then you just have to record it and check it out. Step 5. Launch supported games. Okay, so we're basically done now. Wasn't that fast? It will even be faster the next time you do this. So this step will only tell you how to start games in mixed reality mode. Now, while keeping your headset on here, go to your iOS device, click on start game, and turn on screen recording if you want to record it. There will be a link below on how to turn on screen recording if you don't know how, but once you did that, go back into VR, or actually you should already be in it, quit the Live Connect app and launch a supported game. Most games work straight away, but in a game like Beat Saber, you have to go to settings and turn on mixed reality there before this works, but once you did that, it should work. Now, with your headset still on and Beat Saber 2, walk back to your iOS device and click on Start Game again. Now the screen will turn into a mixed reality video. Remember, if the view doesn't look good, you can recenter or snap turn until it looks nice. For a list of all supported games, you can check out this link, which is in the description. There are some entertaining titles on there, and I'm guessing Live is working on supporting more and more in the future. Now, if you have trouble with any of the steps or the app doesn't seem responsive, I noticed that if you restart your Quest headset, it should work again. Yeah, unfortunately, you have to reboot the whole device and not just the app. And if you want to make your mixed reality recording look a bit better, then two tips: a background with a solid color helps, and better lighting. It's not needed, as you could see in the video, but it helps. Then another quick tip, there's actually a second mode in the iOS app, and that is a spectating feature, a quick and easy way to watch a VR game session from a fixed view without the player visible. This requires no setup, so you can just try that out too if you want. And that's it for this guide, but I did want to mention another viable option, not by Live. This app called Reality Mixer does the same thing, it just has a bit more steps. But if you like to hobby around, you could try that too. For now, I'm really impressed by Live and their team. They've been building their mixed reality tools for years now, and they keep improving, innovating, and making our jobs as content creators easier. And all that for free right now too, which is pretty great. So thanks to them for this app. So let me know if you're going to give this a try, and if you are, send me a link of your capture on Twitter or Instagram. I would love to see it. And if you have any questions, comment them down below and we'll try to answer them at least in the first 24 hours. I also recommend checking out Live's Discord, which has a great support channel. I linked it below. Leave me a like for support and watch more over here. A special thanks go to our champions, especially these bait ones down below. As always, VR on.